Chapter 8. David begins new life with Agnes. After the death of Ham and Steerforth by drowning in the sea, David leaps to Steerforth's house and tells his mother about her son's miserable death. Steerforth's mother was shocked, and finally, as a result, she becomes handicapped and she spends most of her time in her son's room. After the funeral of Steerforth, the travelers made preparation for the coming journey to Australia. David visits people on this journey to Australia. The people who are planning to establish in Australia were Peggotty, Emily, Mr. and Mrs. Mike Eva. Later, David, along with his old aunt, go to Gravesend and they find a ship in the river, which was surrounded by a number of boats. David hires a boat directly and gets through the little vortex of confusion. In the meantime, Mr. Peggotty was waiting for David on the deck. He also takes them between the decks, and David becomes free of any fear or scarcity. When Mr. Mikeyver comes out of dejection, he takes David in his arms and gives him friendship. However, David takes a glance of the place and finds himself on the open part of the ship with Mikeyver, children and Emily. David leaves from this place and he is very much disappointed by the crying of Mrs. Steerforth, and he never tells about the death of Ham and Steerforth to Emily, and Peggotty also shows that everything was fine. David feels shattered now. What do you mean by shattered? He was truly disappointed. He keeps on traveling in Europe, but finally David settles in Switzerland, and for the first time his sorrow takes him in a state of misery. What do you mean by misery? Feeling of great distress or unhappiness after the death of Ham. Dora, his wife, and Steerforth were friends. The only hope in his life is Agnes. And now when he is alone, he realizes how much he loves Agnes. He feels, and he also believes, that he is very weak as compared to Agnes, because she will never accept his proposal and love. Thus, after 3 months passed, David decided to remain away from home for a longer time, as Switzerland was becoming him much dearer. So he decides to settle in the country and to assume his work. Now the memory related to or connected to Agnes strikes him, and he is often in confusion whether Agnes also remembers him or she has forgotten. He gets a packet of letters which came from the village and he reads them. Though they were valuable letters, but David discovered that Agnes is prospering. That means she was accepting his desire, and she had also expressed her love for him. David took the decision of working hard and he started doing so. He wrote stories, and traders helped him in arranging his publication. During the course of work, David made big improvement and he also earned a good income. Slowly David made progress in his work and he was satisfied and he started giving a better performance. However, his desire of returning home, and at the moment he had completed only half portion of his work, which was to be published in the third fiction. Fortunately, David returned home after a long gap of 3 years on a wintry autumn in London. When he reached London, it was dark and raining, and he could see only fog, and he was not able to see anything more. Finally, David was expecting to return home before the festival of Christmas, but he made his presence before this festival, and it was a surprise for his friends and relatives. David first of all visited two traders who was married to Sophie. Although Traders was not a very successful or famous lawyer, but he was satisfied with his life. And Sophie, who was Traders' wife, informs David that she Sophia tells that she had seen Agnes and she was hale and hearty. That means she was in good health and good condition. So David had a dinner with Traddles and his wife Sophie. And after that, David returns to the same inn from where he started his journey for England. And David also plans to go to Canterbury. And there he arranges a horse to complete his journey. And David inquires, that means he wants to know much more about Agnes. And his aunt replied that Agnes had true love for him and she will never disclose it. And the next day David meets Agnes and he observes or he reads that Mr. Wickfield, who was in pink of health, that means his health was fine and his house was very peaceful and calm. David expressed his true feelings towards Agnes and he made confession not to disturb her. Later, David and Traddles join up and go to the prison where Uriah Heep was jailed. And he had been jailed, you know, for what? For cheating a bank account. And they were surprised that Uriah Heep says that he was very happy and he was changing. They also meet Littimer, Stever's servant, who's servant to Stever. And who was also in the prison because he had made a robbery, or you can say of a stealing. With the passage of time, David and Agnes become very close friends. And finally, Agnes realizes that David was the most lucky person whom she had always loved and she had passion or desires for him. And finally, they get married and with the passage of time or course of time, they had 3 children. And once Mr. Peggotty visited them and tells that little Emily was in Australia and she was in well condition. And Mr. Mikeaver, who had become a magistrate then. And after this visit, nobody saw Mr. Peggotty again. All the characters of this novel, Miss Betsy, Mr. Dick and Peggotty, they all live along with David a very happy life. Traddles had become a successful lawyer and was a happy husband too. And finally, David and Agnes, who had always been an inspiration and strength for David, lived a blissful married life. That means their life was full of joy and extremely happy life David and Agnes lived together. So this was the happy ending of this novel.